Well, the hallmark of the challenge in my constituency is the incident of traffic in Apapa. And Apapa has the major ports in Nigeria, the Tinker port and the Apapa port. And you agree with me that the incidence of the traffic, chaotic traffic, has become a recurring decimal. And I recall that the first few weeks when we got to this assembly, I raised a motion on the floor of the House with a view to articulating these issues and with a view to finding a lasting solution to this. The government claimed to rescue the Lagos State government in particular, Bayede Sanwo-Olu, had always been on the forefront on the incident of traffic in Apapa. Just last 2-3 weeks or so, he still invoked a stakeholder meeting. He's never tired. There was a time he collaborated with the Nigerian Port Authority under the airman of the then Adiza, and a call-up system was invoked, and the traffic disappeared. But I don't know what is happening now. It has since returned back to abnormality. And but he's never tired. Even after then, he still called on stakeholder, and I think it's a continuum. But I want to think that going forward, we should be looking at an alternate mode of transportation. We should revive the rail line to cutting these cargoes. Our waterways should be rejuvenated. The waterways in Apapa are navigable waterways that can cut these cargoes in their hundreds, and that will take off most of the vehicles on the road. Then the farm tanks sited in Apapa should be relocated to the Lekki Free Trade Zone. That is where it is designed in the master plan of the state.
Okay.
It should be relocated to the area. The Lekki port should come on board, and that of the Badagry Deep port too, so that we can have several people have asked questions that what is happening to the other ports and other ports in the land, and you be quick to add that it is the decision of the importer to say this is where my goods should land. Don't forget there is a nexus between those items and the market. Because of over 25 million people, already a big market for these people. And some of the challenge too I saw on a visit to some of these ports too is that those roads leaking to some of these ports too are in comatose. So also is the incident of kidnapping and security is more voracious in this area than what we find in Lagos. I am just praying and appealing that of those revenue that we get from the port, something should come back to Lagos State so that we can keep maintaining our roads and keep maintaining our infrastructures. We don't kill the goose that lay the golden egg.
Mm-hmm.
That's something reasonably in the region of a special status of 1% to maintain infrastructure. It is going to be in the long run in the interest of the Nigerian nation.
Mm-hmm.
It will only enhance the activities of the port, and then we can generate more revenue for the national ports. I mean, consolidation, CRF, consolidation revenue fund. It doesn't come to the state, it comes to the nation at large, to enlarge our coast. We don't need to play politics with this. We don't need to play politics. We did.
So why has it been so difficult for the special status thing to be to go through?
And this is where we keep knocking, and you in the media too needed to, assist to ensuring that this comes to fall. I must tell you that, like I said, oil is no longer affordable. We need alternative mode of transportation from customs and excise and activities of the port, agriculture. These are the areas we can generate new funds to run the nation. So we should do what is necessary to ensure that Lagos State does not go under. Look at the incident of the NSAS, for instance. The agitation is not in the purview of this, of Lagos State. Lagos State never controlled the police. But the NSAS was more, the agitation was more potent and ferocious in the state. And look at the colossal damage, the loss of properties and lives in the state. Because this is because Lagos is a mini Nigeria, and it should be attended to as one. Well.